Hello, my dear students and friends. I welcome you all for this session on programmable logic controller with industrial automation. It is a important microcontroller based programming meant for industrial automation, meant for developing real automated machines actually. That is a need of the hour for our country. Now we are in the lockdown period, so suppose if we develop more and more automation based products and machines, even without one's physical presence, we can the automated machine will do all sorts of manufacturing and making and processing of any product and produce more easily without any human intervention. We can be in lockdown, but the machines, automated machines, it will work on 24/7 basis. That way, this particular topic is very important for we engineers. I'm Dr.M.Sethil Kumar. PLC provide dependable high-speed control and monitoring demanded by a wide variety of automated applications. Okay, I'll be skipping some of the titles that I have prepared actually, right? PLC is a solid state programmable electrical or electronic interface that can manipulate, execute and or monitor at a very faster rate the state of a process or communication system. It operates on the basis of programmable data contained in an integral microprocessor based system. It is able to receive and transmit the various types of electrical and electronic signals and can control and monitor practically any kind of mechanical or electrical systems. It has enormous flexibility. It is usually programmed in relay or ladder logic program. So the ladder logic is the main point when it comes to PLC, programmable logic controller. So ladder logic is a type of programming technique or programming language, I could say. See, we have seen many microcontrollers and many electronic devices, starting from PIC microcontroller or 8085 Intel 8085 microprocessor or a microcontroller. So there are many microcontrollers. PLC is also a microcontroller. The latest things are Arduino, Raspberry Pi and other latest electronic devices have come in. So I'll be conducting a session on Arduino also. See, both the PLC and Arduino has got its own advantages and disadvantages also. So let me tell you the advantages of PLC and also the Arduino. The power of PLC is it is a parallel processor, I could say. At a time it can execute, it can control, it can operate many outputs, whereas the Arduino can control one output at a time. One output at a time. It can be a microsecond, millisecond, or a second. But in a split second, Arduino controls only one, whereas the PLC controls many. That is the power of PLC. But price-wise, say in the Amazon, you can purchase an Arduino Nano board for around 250 to 300 rupees or so. The branded PLC costs somewhere around 5,000 to 10,000, but the compatible PLCs are available in Amazon and AliExpress for about 2,000 rupees. But so cost wise, you see, it is almost 8 times more costlier than the Arduino, but some electronic items are built in the PLC already, meaning you have to buy some additional electronic items additionally if you go for the Arduino. So the price will be slightly increasing then, but still Arduino is cheaper, PLC is bit costlier, but PLC is powerful. So we'll see in the following things. The advantages of PLC are less wiring, Wiring between DS and relay contacts are done through PLC program. Easier and faster to make some changes. What I could say is, even while the program is there, while the machine is running, the program is running, PLC is running, you can make the changes in the program. That means in the next cycle, it takes up the new instructions. So that is the flexibility and power of PLC. Troubleshooting is also much more easier. The reliable components, if you use in PLC, then it will work for years actually. But in my view, in my experience, the Arduino is still the reliability and repeatability point of view. It is far way behind that of PLC actually. PLC is most powerful. The PLC developed in 1970s. At that time, it was very costlier, but nowadays it is available at the affordable cost. Various applications. I listed only very few applications. I'll show you the examples in the form of diagrams. You'll get to know more understanding about the PLC. So you see, these are the areas of applications. Whether it is a milk packet or a masala packet or a namkeen sachet or any other products, mechanical product or electromechanical products, all these things are made in automated machines only without any human intervention. So 99%, even in 20, we are in 2020, even this 2020, the all the automated based automation based machines are run by PLCs only, not even Arduino or Raspberry Pi, because PLC are more reliable. Okay, so as I said earlier, now we are in the lockdown period, so we may be confined in our house, but if you develop a machine, that machine without your intervention, it will start making milk packets, it will start it will continuously make the masala packets or namkeen packets automatically without your intervention. So that is why we in India, we are lagging far behind that of America, Europe and China especially. Even China faced some crisis because of the corona, but they have gone ahead when it comes to automation. So that is why they are able to thrive even in this competitive market. But we will be facing a lot of troubles. So time has come. We have to fasten our belt to learn automation based programming and developing automation based machines and products, even in softwares also. So that is the only way for our growth. So this is about a masala packet machine, two row milk packet machine. It is a blister pack tablet making machine. It's a screen printing machine. So you name the product or a produce, it is packaged by PLC based machine only. Okay, selecting a PLC based on number of logical inputs and outputs, memory, number of special I/O modules, scan time, communication, software. There are many different brands available in the market in PLC. Okay, it is like you have many brands for two wheelers and cars, you know, it is something like that. The most popular one, especially in US, is Allen Bradley, Omron, Mitsubishi. I put it in a bigger font because I'll be training you people only on Mitsubishi based or Mitsubishi original or compatible PLC only. Delta, Siemens, Hitachi, Fairtech, Fuji, and many more. Okay, so suppose if you buy Allen Bradley, irrespective of the thing, the ladder logic is the basic programming technique available for all those. But Allen Bradley, they will be selling their software. Using their software only, you can interface, you can infuse the program. Similarly for other things also. So when it comes to Mitsubishi, hereafter I'll be touching upon one and only Mitsubishi, right? So Mitsubishi brand supplied two different softwares actually, GX Developer and GX Works. I'll be extensively using GX Developer for Mitsubishi based PLC boards actually. Okay, The major components of a PLC is power supply, I/O module, processor, programming devices, so on and so forth. Okay, so these are the something about the input. If this is the PLC, these are the input buttons are inputs, or relay switches are input, or sensor, proximity sensor is an input. The contactor, motor, lamp, bulb, fan are all called the outputs. These are the following symbols used in ladder programming. These are the ladder symbol in the ladder programming, a ladder diagram. So this is the normally open, this is the symbol for normally closed, relay or memory coil, output, timer, counter. I will tell you about all these things in the later session actually. Okay, now we will see something about the Mitsubishi based PLC board now straight away. Now PLC based thing, we will be using a Mitsubishi brand only. I said the Mitsubishi brand is available in two variants. So these are the specs. Based on these specs only, you can choose and you can buy the PLC. Okay, like buying a two wheeler. Okay, if you are young, you can buy a 150cc or 200cc bike. If a bit old, even a 100cc or even 75cc bike is sufficient for us, something like that. So when it comes to type of electrical connection, it is available in two variants, 220 volt AC or 24 volt DC. See, actually I am basically a mechanical engineer. I know the in some electrical and electronic information that is required for executing and compiling the PLC based projects, that is sufficient for me. I'm an object oriented programmer. I first fix the object. For that to make that object, I'll start learning the subject required for that particular object. Okay, so Google, when I googled it, Google said that in industries they are using 24 volt DC only, they will be using widely. So I confined myself only with the 24 volt DC type only. The next variant is relay type board, transistor type board. If you use a relay type board, the relay is nothing but relay is exactly equal to a switch. So you are using a switch to switch on and switch off the fan or light, you know. So you are switching it, you are using the switch to manually switch on and switch off the electrical appliances. But in PLC, a switch cannot be, a manual switch cannot be connected directly. So here it is called relay. The relay is electrically switching on and switching off the switch, the appliance. So theoretically speaking, practically speaking, there is no difference between a switch and the relay. Relay is a switch, of course. So if the board has relay, then that means you have a switch already in the board. So you need not buy a separate switch for that. But transistor is also a switch. If your PLC is a transistor based type, you have to buy a relay separately. So that is why I don't want a separate purchase. So I chose relay type board straight away. The next variant is when it comes to transistor, you know, transistor, there are two different types. I don't know much about the transistor. What I know is only these two, the words NPN, PNP. When I googled it, it said most of the people are using NPN based PLC board. So I don't know why they use, but Google said I follow. So I confined myself with NPN type only. Okay, then PLC uses ladder logic. It is a symbol based programming. The Arduino, if you take, Arduino uses C language, C programming language. Okay, so you know about C already. Okay, so but in my view, symbol based programming is something like whether you are driving your vehicle, car, in India or any country, you have symbols, right hand symbol, left hand symbol, the school is nearby, all are signaled with some signboards. So by just reading the observing and reading the signboards, you can operate, you can run your vehicle. It is something like that. In other words, see, I can't see a Oriya movie or a Bengali movie because I don't know Oriya or I don't know the Bengali. Okay, but if you take Charlie Chaplin movie or a cartoon, Tom and Jerry movie, these are language independent. It doesn't have any language. So anybody can see, he can understand about the Charlie Chaplin movie or the cartoon movies. So in that, yeah, on that aspect, the symbol based programming is much more easier to understand, to learn and to practice. Okay. Now we'll slowly get into the PLC technical jargons now. The PLC follows octal number system. PLC follows octal number system. So what we follow now is a decimal system, 0 to 9, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The next digit after 9 is 10. But octal system has only got only 8 digits, 0 to 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7. There is no 8, there is no 9. After 7, it is 10. So 10 to 17, the next is 20 to 27, and it follows that way. Okay, that is over. Just before I said, you know, if you want to buy a two-wheeler, you need a spec. If you want a four-wheeler, based on the spec and based on your requirement will be, you will be choosing the spec and you will be choosing the vehicle. So now, I will be using Mitsubishi compatible. I said already, Mitsubishi compatible PLC board I will be using. Okay. In that, they have many models. They have many models. For example, if you take a Suzuki car, there are many models in the under the Suzuki brand. There are many models under Hyundai, something like that. So Mitsubishi is a brand, but it has many models. I am using 14MR PLC. So let me tell you what is 14, what is MR, what is PLC. The 14 stands for the sum of number of inputs and outputs. Generally, the 14 stands for, it has 8 inputs plus 6 output, 8 plus 6 equal to 14. So that means 14MR means it has the inputs and outputs put together is equal to 14. So instead of 14, if I buy a 20MR or even a 200MR, a 200MR PLC will have the sum of input and output is equal to 200. That's it. I don't know about M actually, but R stands for relay type board. I already said I'll be choosing the relay type board only. Okay, so let me highlight my choice in red color. So these are my choices. Okay, so relay board. In place of R, if it has T, then it is nothing but it is a transistor type. So I said already that I'll be using only the relay board because I need not buy a, if you use a transistor type, you have to buy relay separately because your transistor is also a switch. Even though it is a switch, it's the amperage, the current is not sufficient to switch on a light or a fan. So the only the relay can relay only the relay has the ampere or the power to switch on the lamp or the light fan. Okay, so if you go for transistor, you have to buy additionally, you have to buy the relays. That's what I said. The cost wise, the Arduino boards may be much cheaper, much cheaper than the PLC, but after buying the Arduino, you have to definitely purchase relay. So after purchasing the Arduino and relays all put together, if you see, the cost difference will be, initially the cost difference will be eight times costlier, the PLC. But after adding these things, the cost, it works around maybe three times costlier, maybe. Okay, now come to the Mitsubishi compatible PLC. The Mitsubishi compatible PLC follows the two different distinctive symbols for input and output representation. Okay, I said there are many brands. Take for example, if you use a Siemens, instead of X they use I, instead of Y it use O, I for input, O for output. When it comes to Mitsubishi, it uses X is a symbol for input, Y is a symbol for output. Now I said we'll be using 14mr PLC, so it has 8 input, 8x, 6 outputs, 6 y's. They are x0, x1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 inputs. Always the starting number is 0. It is something similar to C also. Even in C language, the starting number is 0, not 1. So the 6 outputs, y0, y1, y2, y3, y4 and y5. So whether you are using PLC, PLC is also a microcontroller, Arduino is also a microcontroller, the very old version is 8085, I think. Okay, I do not know anything about 8085 because it's a 30-year-old microprocessor, a microcontroller. Why to knock my head on 8085? After that, we saw PIC, Atmel microcontrollers. Most of the BE projects were carried out using PIC and Atmel microcontrollers only. But nowadays, most of the students and project centers are using Arduino and Raspberry Pi nowadays, right? Whether you are using 8085 or the PIC, Atmel, PLC, Arduino, LabVIEW, MATLAB, or any other Xilinx, any microcontroller, you name it, it has three things when it comes to product development, when it comes to automation: the mechanical design, mechanical and electrical design, I could say. Mechanical, electrical design is one component. The other component in a project execution is electrical connection. See, this electrical connection, if you have a good understanding about house wiring, that is really great to execute any type of projects using PLC or Arduino, I could say. I said already I'm a mechanical engineer, but I gained confidence only because of I know the basic house wiring. With that fundamental only, I could able to learn thoroughly about the PLC and Arduino, right? The next part is programming. You see, from this you will come to know that, see, if you learnt PLC programming from my lecture session, learning Arduino, okay, only one third. Even for the Arduino, the mechanical, electric design and electric connection are common whether you use PLC or Arduino. So first learning one electronic programming is it takes time, but adding another electronic module, you can easily do it, you can easily learn it. Okay, I said now basic electrical connections must you know. So you see, the normal AA battery delivers a power of 1.5 VDC, volt direct connection. When it comes to direct DC power supply, the power supply is available in these variants: 1.5 volt, 3 volt, 6 volt, 9 volt, 12 volt, 24 volt. Nowadays, electric bike and electric cars are in the market. So even 96 volt DC also they are using, I came to know that. But we restrict ourselves only with this PLC. In our PLC, we use 24 volt DC type PLC only. So if you want to attach a sensor, if the sensors must be are of 24 volt DC type. If you buy that type of sensors, you can directly fix it in our PLC and directly start using it. So that is it. Of course, they are from the in the output side, you can control any type of thing, because relay is a switch, I said already, no? So you can through the relay, through output Y0 to Y7, Y6, Y5, you can control 220 volt AC light or 220 volt AC fan or a water motor, again 220 volt AC, or sometimes you can use a three phase motors also you can control. So the PLC has got that much power. Okay, so at this point of time, for the today's session, this is sufficient for me or even for you, because if I take some more time, it will be, I think I'll start confusing about the program, the PLC programming. Okay, one thing you keep it in mind, that whether you use PLC, Arduino or any other electronic, you should have the basic mechanical electrical design and the electrical connections. If you know, you can easily learn both PLC as well as Arduino. Okay, thank you. I developed many PLC based products. If you see in my channel, go to YouTube, in the search bar you type EG. EG stands for Engineering Graphics, Senthil Kumar, my name. Then if you press search button, this is my channel logo. After clicking this, if you go to playlist, I arranged all my YouTube videos in topic wise. There is a separate topic or a folder for my PLC based projects. So it has 21 videos, that means 21 projects that I already executed. Okay, so it is something like my very first project was a PLC based PLC coin operated vending setup. The latest last one is a peanut vending machine, of course. So you can choose any one, you can see all this. So in this session, in this 21 days lecture session, I'll be covering all these things. Okay, sometime you'll be seeing my the live connection and live ladder programming, fusing, how to fuse it and how to execute all those products, right? Of course, if you see, presently I am developing a product, a PLC based product. It's a Pani Puri Pani vending machine. So this is a PLC based product actually. So since we are in lockdown period, I can't buy the component which is required to complete this particular product. So I'm not able to purchase those components because of the lockdown. So, but anyway, I'll be in 21 days. It's my promise and it is my pledge also. I'll be completing this also simultaneously. Okay. Thank you.